But before we get into that, again, I want to thank you all for making this happen. We all love Charles, we miss him dearly, and we have to do something, and we pull together as a team to make this happen. So thank you all so much. Okay? I'm going to turn this over to our mission ceremony, Sharon.
Hello, everyone. Family and friends, I want to welcome you all to the Independence Plaza Senior Center. Today we honor the life of Charles Moody. His presence touched the lives of everyone in this center in many ways. Whether it was a show of kindness, caring and patience towards others, generosity, or just his willingness to listen. Charles gained a place in the hearts of everyone. And with that being said, you are now at remembrances of Charles.
Our sadness is overwhelming, and I have a little poem that was in the graveyard of where my son is. He died in Iraq in 2004, and this was from Dorothy Freeman, and I will give you the small poem afterwards. In the kiss of the sun, there is pardon. In the song of the bird, there is merit. You are never nearer God than in the garden, than any other place on earth. I want to say that Charles, he brought so much to this center because he had compassion and understanding for all and everyone in particular. Particularly, he was very, very kind, considerate, and loved by us. And there's not enough words to say how much we miss this person. And we hope we should rest with God as we send him.
Good morning, Charles. When he got, and I said good morning to him, his voice.
Good morning, Reedy.
And when Nicole got that little, when Nicole got that little toy of his, that table boy, that school is too hard. He should have been singing opera. Anyway, Vaseline and for every 10 years, his response set the tone for the day. Charles was hard as a kitchen aid, but he soon lost that title because he became a member of our family, a cousin, a nephew, a godfather, and just a lovely person. But soon after that, he would, I have to describe Charles, and I think all of you can do the same thing too. He was kind, respectable, caring, helpful, sincere. An individual like that, who will never run out of apathy. I have to describe him. Once a week, I found out that we were both tea drinkers. I would bring all my fancy teas. And I brought some examples of teas I used to give him. They're in the table for your table, for your table. Including some English tea, all right? And tea of today. Now, Charles, and then we found out also that his mother loved mysteries. And her favorite author was Mary Higgins Clark, our famous Irish woman. And we are also. So we would change books. And on Christmas, I would give him a book for her to give up for Christmas from Mary Higgins Clark. But one day, without warning, our house of cards collapsed. Charles had left us. His absence today has left us a void in our hearts. We all need closure. Hence, today's memory. Good night, Charles. It was one heck of a life.
Good afternoon.
Good
I just want to say, I have not known Charles as long as some of you may have known. But since I've been here, since I've been coming here, I found Charles to be a very special man. And he was a special person. And he loved, someone said he loved, he was kind, he was a gentleman. But one thing that struck me was I would come in and I would always be looking for decaffeinated tea. I never had decaffeinated tea. So one day, I just happened to ask him, decaffeinated tea? He said, no, we don't serve decaffeinated tea here. I said, oh, okay. I guess I'll have to just drink the regular tea. But I came in one day and there was a box of decaffeinated tea. That he had bought just for me. Every time I come to the center, he would go up in the closet and get down that box of decaffeinated tea just for me. That's how special he was. I didn't ask him to do that, but his heart, he had a kind heart. And he thought about the seniors here. I believe he loved every one of the seniors here. And I'm glad that I was part of that group.
Hi, I love Charles, even though I never got the I love Charles really and his joyous bursts of laughter. He was such a warm,
I looked around this garden. Hi, I'm Sally. I have known Charles since 2011. And the most thing I remember about Charles is when we talked about the movie. And we became our own movie critics. And he always was telling me, oh, I'm going to movie with my cousin. I don't know if that's you're the cousin.
Yes.
And then we'll come back and we discuss it over the weekend. And he always will tell me, it's our little private joke between us. He said, you know what, Sally? I'm glad I'm not your boyfriend. And I said, why? Because I have a very good appetite. I'd rather buy you clothes than to feed you. I'm gonna end my little words and with this. I'm saying opportunity knocks on you once. But Charles was my opportunity to him and to myself. That's part of a problem. And thank you all for listening to me.
Even in his absence, one day I was in the kitchen and
And they was like, don't worry about this, we got this here because this is how Charles did it. This is how Charles did it. I just want you to know that he is definitely loved, not only by us seniors here, but all the kids that come from the college to volunteer. So we truly, truly, I truly, truly miss him.
Yes.
Thank you.
Charles's legacy and integrity. I shall, however, try my best to honor Charles, and please forgive if I leave out of any Charles's good qualities that I don't know of. I was not close to him as many of you were from years of knowing him. Charles gave my special attention and consideration simply because he was a very compassionate and caring person, and I'm just a disabled old man. Toward the end of the lunch hours, Charles would find time listening to the life stories. I'm sorry, y'all. And even gave good and thoughtful counseling. People like Ann Landers, Dr. Joyce Brothers. And at closing, he would give food away to those who needed a second. Charles was indeed our food manager, caregiver, as well as psychologist. Though sadly, he only got compensated for the one hardest job that hardly anyone wants to do. Anything else he did for us was a gift from his kind heart. Losing Charles is like losing one of our own, a dear brother of the British House family. It hurts and it pains our heart. But despite the loss of sadness, we all can find some comfort in knowing that Charles is in a better and tranquil place now, where there's no pain and no suffering. He is with his God, and with God, he will always watch over us from above and make sure we all have our healthy meals daily. Though Charles' passing has left an immense pain, he also has given us a cherished memory of him as a great friend and a wonderful son to his mother. So let's rejoice in this beautiful memory of Charles. A little bit more to say. Because Charles was a faithful Catholic and has some Irish blood in him, I wish to offer here a farewell to Charles. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always behind, always at your back. May the sun shine warm on your face. May the rain fall softly on the fields until we meet again. And may God hold you in the hollow of his hand. Shy song.
see you today, and I want to honor the first lady who spoke, her son's sacrifice in this great country. I hit it off from the very earliest days when I was a little kid. We had the same likes. We loved monster and horror and science fiction movies from the earliest days, and I couldn't wait till he was coming to stay over our house for a weekend, and we became best friends from the earliest days, and we started going to the movies around the mid-80s, and just loved going to the movies, and I was very dedicated to him and his mom, taking them to all the family outings. They didn't drive, they had no way of getting around, and I would drive hundreds of miles. I didn't care, I loved them so much. And I brought them to all the family parties, and I just look forward to always seeing Charles. We got together every 2 or 3 weeks for many, many years, and just had the greatest time. I always look forward to spring weather coming, because we used to take walks through Flushing Meadow Park, and we visited all the Casino Park, and all. It was just great getting out and walking. He always had good wheels. He said he could walk endless miles. I always look forward to it, and we had so many things planned. It's sad that he's gone, but we used to go to the Museum of Natural History at least once a year. We always loved him with the dinosaur bones. Just stuff right up our alley. He's a wonderful guy. We had the best relationship. And a couple of years ago, my brother gave me his old DVD player that we used to watch all of our favorite television shows in the car. It was like he couldn't wait to see me read these messages, singing songs from shows that we were going to be watching. And I spent endless money buying him television shows, too, because I just wanted to enrich his life. And I know it was such a blessing to him, all our favorite shows in the 60s. And we just had an endless collection of stuff that I got him, and I miss him dearly, too. And just hearing all these things from you wonderful folks, what he did here, I only knew a little bit of it, but I it's incredible what a good man he was. And you know, I'm really honored to be here to represent our family in his behalf, and I miss him so much.
Thank you.
Yes. This is my niece Pam. She was given it in 2002. She was about 16. It's A Shepherd Looks at Psalm 23. It's a great book. It's an analogy of how a shepherd takes care of his sheep, an analogy to how the Lord takes care of us as a sheep. And it says, he shall feed his flock like a shepherd. He shall gather the lambs with his arms and carry them in his bosom, and shall gently lead those that are his young. And I just wrote a little something in here. This book is for Nicole, too. It says, in memory of our beloved cousin and godchild, Charles G. Moody, this book's inspiration on his life of how Jesus Yeshua, as our shepherd, takes great care of us, his sheep, can bless all who read these precious words that blessed him. A gift to Nicole Brown, whom God has chosen as a shepherd to guide and protect her flocks with a tender hand. But it's a great book, and anyone that wants to read it, it's a wonderful analogy of how a shepherd has to really look closely at his sheep. Yeah, and when we were in the hospital, to see me so many times in the hospital, and I was reading passages out of here, and it just touched his spirit as he was laying there on his bed. And I wish his mom could be here now, but she really is, as you can imagine, devastated over it. And you know, we just pray every day for her that she'll rebound, you know, because I know he would want her to go on and live a prosperous life. He doesn't want to see her demise. So he is in a better place. He's with our Lord and Savior, and I thank you all again for having us.
Overwhelming, so phenomenal to be here. story that somebody told me. You know, the Lord said, don't forsake the assembling of one another. So that it's not that we're gathering, but when we assemble, it's like the parts of a car. You could put those parts in your driveway, and you've got all the parts, but until you assemble them, the car can't go. And I love that analogy, and I've always thought about it. And that's who we are together. And even Nicole was saying, let's always have love amongst us. It's not always easy, but when you seek God first and His kingdom, He says everything else is going to be added, including helping us fix our emotions. Give it all to Him. And I know that's what Charles did all the time. We spent a lot of times together. He stayed to live with us for a little bit. What a great blessing that was. And since he was my godchild, I remember holding him. What a beautiful baby. In fact, we have photographs of him. Baby and grown up, handsome, absolutely handsome. Even handsome to the very end, every day in the hospital, even in his casket. He looked beautiful. And I was so blessed to know that this is this little baby in my charge. And so he gave me many opportunities to share with him, and he received that truth about God and was able to implement it in his life, because he had many challenges which he overcame, and I'm so proud of him. And the one thing he never overcame was the smoking, and of course, it was the cancer that took his life. But I want to say something here too. I just in hearing all of these wonderful testimonials about the relationship, this is therapy for us, all of us. This is so important. We don't have to pay a shrink. We just have to and by the way, the lady, the Irish, I'm Italian and Irish. My mom was 98 in great condition, living in Florida, was born in Belfast. So she's part of the history of this family too, and still going. But I chose to wear green, the wearing of the green, because I'm Irish as well. And there's a certain pride that we all have when we come from family ties that care about one another. And look, you are family. You are the larger family to Charles. I'm so grateful for that. And isn't it interesting, all the years that we may have had with him, we don't know everything intimately that you folks came to see in his life and enjoy and be taken care of. And I know that God's word is very powerful. I've come to understand that as a believer. And more recently, I've been studying the Hebrew roots of our faith, and that is a glorious thing to really capture the Hebrew translation of the word. It's just a magnificent thing. And so the more that we spend time with God, the more we know him, and that's what he wants. He wants us to know him, because his promises are always to take care of us. And when we know that there's peace and there's comfort in it, and I'm always picking out scripture cards to include in cards, and I always pick them out of my Father, give us a word from you. And this is what I picked out for us for today, and it was from the Lord, and it says, when he hath tried me, I shall come forth as gold. It's from the book of Job, and I dare say, we have all been tried on some level, and it's for a purpose. I'm sharing with Nicole. The trials that we know for growing, they're painful sometimes. We all know on some level some pain, but the purpose is to grow and to build our faith, and it's always for a purpose. It's never, God never neglects his care, especially if we dare to trust him. So we've been doing this for well over 40 years, and I'm so grateful for that. And the other side of this says, For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. And Matt and I talk about, we all talk about the family. Sometimes our jobs create a lot of problems for us, and sometimes the people we work for don't do. Put all the work on us.
Right.
But anyway, it's that when you have an attitude that we do everything as unto the Lord and not to men, then the blessings are always forthcoming, because people can disappoint us. But I'm so grateful and comforted that Charles never disappointed any of you. And he never disappointed any of us. And I'm so grateful for that. And I thank God. When we spent the time in the hospital with him, reading to him, and he loved, absolutely loved that story, because it's so interesting. The care of sheep is frightening when you think of it. It's life-threatening to the shepherd. They need so much particular care. But when you read it, it's so interesting historically and like a documentary. It's that care that Jesus Yeshua gives to us. It's amazing. But when I stayed over in hospital 4 nights and 5 days, and in the hospice room that they supplied, and I dare say the care was excellent. They were very attentive to him, and they kept him out of pain. Praise God. And he always looked great, and he was always responding. We thought he was sleeping, but he was awake and responding.
He always had that strong voice.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, my God. Yes.
He never lost his
always.
Voice.
Yes. 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 That strong voice. It was like, whoa. But anyway, I was not there the night he passed, and my aunt Eileen, what a dear person she has always been. We're only 5 years apart. She's 5 years older than I, but we grew up together. And I remember the great times I would hang out with them. I was just a kid, maybe 9 years old, to 14. I was like the mascot in Bay Ridge. And they always made a bus over me. And I was like, oh my gosh, I was like a little celebrity in the group of teenagers. So we had a great time, and we lived with family for several years on Long Island in Wantagh. And then they moved, and they had their own place. And then this precious Charles was born to Eileen and Jerry Mooney. And he didn't have his father for long enough. So there was a sadness there and missing out on the care of the father. But his mother did a beautiful job. And we are heartbroken because we don't want her to be in such pain. And we do keep in touch, and my daughter, we have all visited, we talked to her on the phone. So I know that prayer makes a difference. So we're just gonna believe God that he's with her. I want her to know that. I want her to recognize that, and to be able to know that he is the one who comes to heal the brokenhearted. He does everything else. Scripture that I live by. I'm so grateful for it. All the scriptures are gorgeous and full of power and full of life. But it's Ephesians 3:20, and it's the one that says it's by the power that he's put in us because we've invited him in. His power is within us, and by that power, he can do exceeding abundantly above all we could think or ask. And that's what every single day, even our getting here, even our being able to meet with you people. And I am just so overwhelmed and so blessed. Thank you, every one of you, who so showed up today and appreciated Charles, our beloved Charles. It's given us such a freedom to enjoy him on a whole other level. Thank you. This has healed our souls just being together. So I bless all of you. What whatever you have to do, do it as unto the Lord. It's going to be a success, just like Charles did. Thank you so much.
Of like your friendship and who you guys were to each other. And you know, we might hear stories or something like that, and it's funny and wonderful, and people's names and everything like that, and now faces to names and stuff like that. And I'm so, like my mom said, like my brother said, we're so overwhelmed with the love in this room. And again, it's like turning this moment that was so unexpected,
right,
with Charles, and like tragic for us as a family and for my aunt. And this is so warm and loving and incredible. And I feel like you guys are such an extension of the family at this point, which is so, so nice. And I just wanted to thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'm going to sing a little song, because Chaz, as we called him, we all just called him Chaz. We used to do that at some family gatherings and stuff like that. And this is one of the songs that he always liked. And I just wanted to do this for you guys. If I can get through it.
Rainbow flow. someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up when the clouds are far behind me.
You must just